Diakar, Vivek, our chairman Suhas, all of our board members who are present today, and our chamber team to please come up so we can get a quick group photo. And while we are doing that, I want to have everyone kind of make their way slowly. We have about 45 minutes for lunch, so make your way slowly over. Lunches are over here on the right side.
And our goal on this panel today actually is to develop the ecosystem here in Dallas, specifically on how you can merge academia, entrepreneurship, investment, and industry. And so, very fortunate to have these gentlemen here, and hopefully we'll have a fun experience. Worst case, I do stand-up comedy, and I'll try to do that too. So Neil did a great job of introducing.
Then was away from Dallas in the Midwest and mostly in Seattle for 15 years and then came back 6 years ago. I do have an association to Dallas because I also went to UT Arlington for two different degrees in engineering and information systems. I think what has helped me reach this level and be successful is taking a lot of risks, a lot of experimentation from.
I wrote a matrimonial software in 99, and it sent an email to a lot of people, and it has my matrimonial ad, that this is the guy who wanted to get married, and I got married by a spam email that I sent. And I love my wife, we are married. This is our 18th year, we're blessed with two daughters, 15 and 8, so this is
it's on 665, a very significant scale onto that, and we want to do things, attempt new things. Fun fact about me, I'm a very passionate cook, and I like to learn things. I've worked in Chick-fil-A as a fryer, frying and making burgers, when I was a director at Capital One, so not for initial things, and then I worked at Rusty Taco for, please don't quote me on that.
You know, one last question on the entrepreneur side before we pivot to your investment career. The last question I have for you, and obviously this comes up for entrepreneurs, it's product market fit. That's a topic that, every investor wants to hear from entrepreneurs. And in our conversation yesterday, you had a unique twist to it. So I'd love for you to talk about that a little bit.
So I get this question a lot of times, what is product market fit and how important is it in the life of a startup? What I like to say is, for a startup, it is not a little bit about product market fit, it is everything about product market fit. That is all you have to focus in on. So what does product market fit mean? Product market fit is about discovering the non-obvious insight.
And my question is, for the startups, I've heard that for the Silicon Valley model, you give it away, that's the blitz scaling hockey stick growth. But then other ones have said for the MBA model, it's better to get the revenue and have the customer pay for it. So what's the pros and the cons?
Then I would drive towards being cash flow break even as quickly as possible and manage your growth in a measured way. If you're resource constrained because you have found that product market fit and now you need people to service that demand, and if you don't service that demand, trust me, that demand is getting serviced by someone, just not you.
I will take the similar question to Angel as well, but from a perspective of a much later stage. And by the way, Angel's firm does an average check size of about $50 million. So the question really is the same, but I'd love to hear your criteria on analyzing these investments.
It's one thing to say, I will get to profitability, but it's another thing to show that from a unit economics level, at least, you don't need to be profitable at the company, but at a unit level, you are profitable. That when you acquire these customers online or however you acquire them, they eventually pay back. So we're much more metrics focused because there is actually history and data to analyze once companies reach scale. And the third important factor is the defensibility of the business model. So there are a lot.
We're probably one of the leading funds in the area. based on the amount of knowledge and expertise we have on the team, both on the financial side, this is where I come in, and also on the technical side and product management side. So we have a large engineering organization as part of Verizon. We have successfully built the best, we would like to believe, 4G networks in the country and in the world. And we're currently working on building the next generation 5G network.
Exciting.
A company and the founding team for a while and getting to know them and build trust on both sides. And a lot of that trust building and rapport building, as Angel mentioned, is important because a lot of the value that we're bringing is essentially mentoring, coaching. We are kind of psychologists or psychiatrists for a lot of founders as well. It's a lot of, like, you know, it's lonely being the CEO, especially as a founder, because it is so bleak in terms of what might be kind of right around the corner. Can you make payroll? These kinds of things.